Good morning. It's been a while since we've sat and talked in the morning and had coffee or tea.
"'Twas the night before Christmas, and all..."
This is my favorite version of this song.
"The winter was stirring."
Doesn't seem like Christmas.
"If I'm mad..."
Until I hear it. It's the Temptations version of Silent Night. I never heard this song before December 1986. It was my first Christmas with Teresa. And this song came on. Pretty cool stuff.
Merry Christmas to me, to all of you.
I wish I could sing like this. Look. Cool stuff. Yeah, I like it. It's a good song. I hope you guys are having a good holiday season so far. Christmas is coming up, and for those of us who are dealing with a loss, we can find joy in the holiday. We can. We can. It doesn't have to be a super sad time. There's going to be sadness. There always is. But until we're touched by the death of someone that we love, it just makes all other losses pale in comparison. But you know, we have to go on. We have to. Me, God has blessed me with children to motivate me so that, you know, I look in their faces and, you know, they need me to lead them and to guide them. You know, I told you that Mimi had a friend over. Poor child was so naive. This boy's trying to get a kiss and she didn't even know. I mean, she honestly had no idea. And when I looked in there, you know, she had her hands up. Made a wall out of her hands and had her hands on her face, and I'm like, honey, all you have to do is tell the boy to get out of your personal space. And sometimes it doesn't work, but that's what daddy's here for. But yeah, Jesus all up in her grill, and she didn't know what was going on. I'm like, honey, he walked all the way over to your house about a mile and got lost in a strange neighborhood. I guess he thought he was entitled to a kiss. Yeah. He was a nice kid, though. He didn't get too forward. When I told him to get on the other seat, yeah, not a problem. But I say that because it's things like that that keeps me going forward, you know? There's no time to lay down. Not for grief. Would your loved one want you to? They want you to just stop living and stop celebrating Christmas. I mean, if you put up a Christmas tree your whole life with that person that you loved, And because they're not here with you now, you're not going to do it? Really? I'll pray for you and hope that you find the strength and comfort to do it, because it is the right thing to do. We have to carry on. Not only carry on, carry better, move forward in a more positive direction, and help as many people as we can along the way. No, one person can't save the world, but collectively we are the world. Can we save ourselves? I pray we can. I think so, because there's definitely more good in the world than bad. Trust me, I was in the news. You know, it's just the bad stuff that makes the news. You know, they're just not going to do stories about the 79-year-old lady who's been making apple butter at the church bazaar for 30 years and does it with a smile on her face. You know, it's a crapshoot to get that story on the news. So, even though the news is essential because it does let us know vital information, at the same time, a lot of it is bad and depressive, you know. Car wrecks, murder, corruption, you name it, and, you know, all of those types of stories. And hey, I'm just like you, I tune in and I watch and think, oh my, he did what, or oh my, they're going through that. But remember, for everything that we do see, negative, there are 10 positive things that are happening that, you know, we're just not going to know about. Only the people affected by them will. And, you know, miracles, unless they're actually caught on tape, you don't see those. And even when they are caught on tape, people figure out ways to try to convince you that you're not seeing what you saw. Got to have faith, my friend. My faith is keeping me strong, keeping me focused for my girls. It is my compass. And the thing I like about this faith compass, I was in the Army, so we had to be trained on those regular compass, you know, I shouldn't say regular, the original compass. They're actually kind of hard to read and kind of easy to read, and, you know, you have to find north. You know, north sets up your compass. And the thing about the spiritual compass of faith is finding north is always easy. Look up. Look up, my friend. Set your compass straight. So I hope you have a great day. I don't know what I'm going to do today. Well, I do know that my mother-in-law wants to take the girls out shopping, and the young ladies are inclined to let her. You know how teenagers are. You mentioned shopping to two teenage girls. Good grief. Now, there is a carrot that you could dangle in front of the horse and get that horse to climb a mountain. Let's see. Is there a carrot that I could dangle? No. I feel like Kathleen Turner's character in that movie, The War of the Roses. Remember in that story, at one point, you know, she set her mind to setting up her house, making her house look, you know, her dream home look like she wanted it to. And at the end of the process, you know, they show her sitting this little ladro knick-knack down on a shelf, and it said, you know, she got to the point where she was done. What does she do now? I say that because I feel that way, because, you know, the house is together. I can't dangle a carrot in front of the girls. There's nothing for me to have them do. You know, they are doing a fine job of housekeeping with me. And so, you know, I can sit here on a Sunday morning and talk to you and visit with you, and it actually feels good, because I'm getting stronger every day, and I know it's your prayers and your thoughts, and, you know, part of it, in all honesty, I'm just flattered by the interest in our humble little story, but it is a story of survival, because we will survive with God's grace and mercy and your help, because you have helped a lot. So here's my cup of coffee to you. Clink to you. God bless you all. I hope you have a wonderful Sunday. I'll check in with you later, and maybe I'll sing, maybe I won't. I don't know. You know, if you want me to, go ahead and post a little comment box down there. But I'll definitely check in with you guys later. And I haven't forgotten. I know I need to finish my story about Venezuela. We left off with me actually making the plane. Wow. Something should have told me that that trip was going to be, well, a trip. But I will touch base with you later. Have a great day.